This is verse 23 of the 20th chapter of the Gospel of John. We have Jesus who has just conferred on the disciples the breath, the Holy Spirit. We've indicated it really represents in some ways a moment of a new creation, borrowing that word that was used in the Old Testament connected to the original creation. And then we have this very interesting and really fairly controversial conferring of authority that takes place in the very next verse. So we have on. This is actually a contraction of aeon. It means if, in its basic sense. It's used with the subjunctive. Here, in connection with the indefinite pronoun that we have in the genitive plural masculine, those two taken together are usually rendered something like whoever. So it's a very sweeping word. And that's the idea. It takes the subjunctive, so that's what we have here, the subjunctive of aphemi, which means to leave or to forgive. That's the idea. This is the second person plural, aorist active subjunctive. So whoever, you, that is the second person plural, you forgive, whoever you forgive, and then tos, the feminine accusative plural article, with hamartios, the sins, so whoever you forgive the sins, to whomever you forgive them. Then same word here, aphemi, but in this case now it's the third person plural perfect, passive indicative, they are forgiven. So you forgive the sins, they are forgiven, forgiven to them. So autois here, the dative plural masculine pronoun. So whoever you forgive the sins, they are forgiven to them. Same construction here, so whoever, kratate, this is from krateo. Basic meaning is power. Krotos or kratos means kind of a power, democrat, the idea, autocrat, words we get in English from that. In this case, it has the idea of hanging on to something with power. This is the second person plural. Present active indicative. So whoever you retain, impliedly again, the sins that are referred to earlier. Same word here, kekratein tai. This is from krateo. Same idea. They are retained. They are hung on to. Of course, you know that in history there's been quite a difference of opinion. The Catholic Church has generally assumed that this refers to the distinct authority conferred on the priests. In the Protestant tradition, there's more an idea that this is simply giving great weight and dignity to the office of the Church and the capacity of the pastor to declare sins forgiven, of course, with an understanding that that is conditioned on the fact that the person is repentant, and it's a declaration of the forgiving heart of God toward repentant people rather than some kind of unilateral authority, which is somewhat more akin to the Catholic view. So I'm not going to try to resolve that at this point, but these are the simple terms that are used here. So whoever sins you forgive, they stand forgiven. That's the really authority that we have in the traditions that declare a statement of benediction, a statement of forgiveness, an assurance of pardon, sometimes called. Whoever's sins you retain, based evidently on a refusal to repent, on a refusal to bow the knee before King Jesus, those sins are retained. And Jesus now combines his conferring of the Holy Spirit upon them in this new creation with a kind of sanction associated with the new creation, namely that connected to entrance into the new creation by means of the forgiveness of sins.